I want to go sailing, but what's the weather going to be like? Well, most of us may turn on the radio or the TV or go on the internet or even listen to maybe the marine weather and get a weather forecast. But when you do, keep a few things in mind. First is accuracy. Local radio and TV forecasts tend to be not very accurate. Government agencies a little more so. Predicting weather is an inexact science at the very best of times. There are just too many variables. When you see it says a 30% chance of precipitation, it only means that there is a 1 in 3 chance that your rain gauge will get 0.1 of an inch of rain or more in that particular period. It says nothing about how long the rain will last or how heavy it will be. Small boat cruising shouldn't just be reserved for the rich. I believe we all should be allowed to take the time to enjoy the adventure. Let's get ready, learn a few necessary skills, find a boat, and take off for the adventures of our lives. I'm Allan Stokell, and this is Budget Boat Cruising. So, and it also says nothing about what happened in that day in the past. Also, the longer the forecast is, for the lower the accuracy is. Fairly accurate forecasts for the same day are quite reliable. But if you rely on a 5-day or less forecast, every day it's inaccurate by 10% or more a day. Add to that, most TV weather people are not meteorologists, so they know about as much as I do. Me! Now, there's no guarantee of accuracy, even when these forecasters use all the latest technology, such as satellites and radar and Doppler. And there can be some amazing logarithms, but I have my own way of forecasting weather. My system has been used for centuries and is 100% accurate. I know what you're thinking. It's a weather rock. If the rock is wet, it's raining. If the rock is swinging, the wind is blowing. If the rock casts a shadow, the sun is shining. If the rock does not cast a shadow and is not wet, then the sky is just cloudy. If the rock is not visible, it must be foggy. By the way, I don't use a weather rock. My predictions come from a higher source, the sky. It's a great way of supplementing your best weather forecast. Now you can do it too. I urge you to keep a weather log. Observe changes that you have observed during this weather log. And it's even better if you have a barometer. The stormy rain change fair, very dry markings, was added to barometers in the early 20th century to try to sell them as weather predictors. In fact, it is the change or tendency that helps predict the weather, not the barometer. Here are a few cloud formations you will see in the northern hemisphere. Fair weather cumulus. Normally, cumulus clouds produce little or no precipitation, but they can grow into the precipitation-bearing cumulonimbus clouds. Stratus clouds usually predict poor weather is coming. These clouds are essentially above-ground fog that forms either through the lifting of morning fog or through cold air moving at low altitudes over a region. They also can forecast light rain. Stratocumulus. These clouds are low, lumpy, and gray. These clouds can look like cells under a microscope. They may look like fish scales, and sometimes they line up in rows, and other times they spread out. Only light precipitation, generally in the form of drizzle, occurs with stratocumulus clouds. Cumulonimbus. They are generally known as thunderstorm clouds. A cumulonimbus cloud can grow up to 10 kilometers high. At this height, high winds will often flatten the top of the cloud to make it look like it's anvil-shaped. Cumulonimbus clouds are associated with heavy rain, hail, lightning, and tornadoes. Watch out for these. Altocumulus clouds are grayish-white, with one part of the cloud darker than the other. Altocumulus clouds usually form in groups and are about 1 kilometer thick. If you see these altocumulus clouds on a warm, humid morning, then expect thunderstorms by late afternoon. Altostratus clouds usually cover the whole sky and have a gray or blue-gray appearance. The sun or moon may shine through as a altostratus cloud, but will appear rather watery or fuzzy. An altostratus cloud usually forms ahead of a storm that has continuous rain. Occasionally, the rain will fall from a altostratus cloud, but if the rain hits the ground, then the cloud becomes classified as a nimbostratus cloud. Nimbostratus are dark gray with a ragged base. Nimbostratus clouds are associated with continuous rain. Sometimes they cover the whole sky, and you can't even see the edges of the cloud. You can tell where the weather will come from by observing wind direction and the barometric pressure. Wind direction changes often, and it's accompanied by changes in the weather. The air flows cyclonically around a pressure system. If the wind changes direction in a cyclonic fashion, it often means low pressure or a front is influencing the area. A wind shifting from the south, for instance, means that warmer air is approaching, and wind from the north often means cooler air is approaching. When the wind changes abruptly, it could be a frontal passage or wind direction change caused by a thunderstorm. As a rule in my area, winds from the east quadrant and falling barometric pressure indicate foul weather, and winds shifting to the western quadrant indicate clearing and fair weather. But there are exceptions. So that's it. I'd love to hear your comments and suggestions. Please type them below, or you can email me. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe. You may also like my Listen to Grandpa rant, How to Talk Like a Sailor, my stealth camping videos, or my World's Worst Maritime Disasters channel. It's always a critic. I'm Allan Stokell, and thanks for watching.